They'll be afraid of you. They say every time you come and ask money, they will think that you're taking advantage of them because they send you to school. They don't know that it's true that they're asking you for the money. That was why you keep on asking your parents for the money. But in hello family, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the difference between Nigerian University and Ghana University. So let me start like this. So every parent wants their child to go to a better university. Nobody wants to send his child to university that is not good or any other thing like that. Everybody wants their child to go to a better university, so because they will not just go and waste their money on their child. At the end of the day, the child is not well educated. Everybody wants their child to go to university that the child will be well educated at the end of the year. So, and in Nigeria, so let me start with Nigeria University. In Nigeria, if you want to go to Nigeria University or you want to apply in Nigeria University, you must know somebody, that somebody will know somebody, that will know somebody, that will know somebody, that will know somebody, before you can apply to any Nigeria University, because you cannot just go and just submit your this thing, your admission letter, and they will just accept you just like that. You need to know somebody that will know somebody that will know somebody before they will admit you into any university in Nigeria. But in Ghana, if you want to apply into any university, you don't need to know somebody that will know somebody that will know somebody before they are accepted into any university. Just imagine, I wish in Ghana you will know somebody that will know somebody, because you now, you are not from Ghana. You are not from Ghana, you want to enroll into university. Ah, they won't accept you now, because you don't know anybody in Ghana. But in Ghana, it's not like that. In Ghana, it's not like that. And in Nigeria, so in Nigeria, you need to bring your WAEC, your NECO, your GCE, and the school exam as well. So you need to pass all this one. Even if you pass all this one, it doesn't end there. It doesn't end there. You will not come and be stamping one book. They will say you should bring this paperwork, that paperwork, that paperwork, because you want to enter into university. You'll just be running around. And after you look for all these things, then you will not come and start paying some money that you don't even supposed to pay. But in Ghana, it doesn't work like that. You will just bring only your WAEC result. You will submit only your WAEC result. They will accept you into any university that you want, as far as you can pay for the school fees. As far as you can pay for the school fees. Handouts are not expensive. And there's some people say, and Ghana school is very expensive. If you compare Ghana school with Nigeria school now, the one that you'll be paying for, you pay for this one, you pay for that one, you pay for this one. If you calculate all the money and add it together, then it's not even up to the money you pay in Ghana. But some people, they don't know it like that. They don't know it like that. So are you talking about the hostels in Ghana? The hostels in Ghana, you will see boys and girls stay in the same hostels in Ghana. It doesn't mean anything. You will see maybe this room now, there's a girl in this room. The other room, you will see boy in the room. And the third room, you will see girl like that. They are living peacefully in the hostel. In Nigeria, boys and girls doesn't stay together in the hostel. You will have boys hostel and girls hostel. And in Ghana, you can go out to the library and study what sort of time you like. In Nigeria, they will give you a time that you go and study in the library. They will give you the time that you come to the hostel. They will say, so study time, you will not go out from the hostel. This time, you will not go out. But in Ghana, you can go out from the hostel anytime you like. And so that is how it's supposed to be. You need to enjoy your life when you are in the university. So if you didn't enjoy your life when you are in the university, it's when you get married that you come and be enjoying your youthful age. But in Nigeria, it doesn't work like that. They will not allow you to go out. In some university, maybe all this Christian university, they will say, see the clothes you will be putting on to school. See the this thing you will be wearing. You are not going to be wearing trousers in the university. So it wasn't supposed to be so. They should allow them to enjoy themselves because they are in the university at that time. So I prefer Ghana University 100%. Because everything is easy. You will enjoy yourself in the campus. Campus life is very easy. Campus life is very easy in Ghana. And the education, they help you in all ways that you need their help. If you are not the person that is as in brilliant that much, you can't catch up that much. You will enroll for extra class. Extra class, they will teach you and they help you. Just imagine, they don't even know you. You come from another country to come to study in the country. They will just help you as if you are their citizen. In Nigeria, you that is the citizen of Nigeria, they cannot even help you. They cannot even put you through in that university. All they want is money, 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 money. It doesn't supposed to be so. They don't want our young people to study. They don't want our young people to study. When they are calling money, 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 your parents will be fed up. They will be fed up. They will be fed up. They say every time you come and ask money, they will think that you're taking advantage of them because they send you to school. They don't know that it's true that they're asking you for the money. That was why you keep on asking your parents for the money. But in Ghana, they don't do it like that. It doesn't work like that. That is why Ghana University is far off better. Ghana University is far off better. It's far off better. The handout is okay. It's cheaper. It's cheaper. The educational system is good. The lab, everything is there in the lab. Not that in some university in Nigeria, it's a university in Nigeria, you will see that they say in the lab, they are short of this, in the lab, they are short of that in the lab. In the lab, they are not supposed to be shortage of anything in the lab. Everything is supposed to be in the lab because people come to school to study. And everything is supposed to be in the school that will be available for the studies of every student. Not that they are shorting of this in the lab, they are shortage of that in the lab. It's not supposed to be so. It doesn't supposed to be so. You can ask for help from anyone. You can ask for help from anyone. And they are ready to help you. Everybody is ready to help you. Everybody is ready to help. Because that is what you come for. That is what you come from in the school. Everybody is ready to help you. They are not asking you for money in return. In Ghana University, they don't ask you for money in return that they want to help you. You must pay so amount for the help. After all, you've already paid your school fees. So everybody is ready. Everybody is ready. They want you to come out with flying color. They want you to be better. They want you to be better. And that is how university is supposed to be. They want you to be better. It's not that some university in where I come from, you graduate from the university. You don't even know your left from your right. You graduate from the university, somebody will be asking you a question. You that is a graduate, you cannot even answer the question that the person is asking you, and you call yourself a graduate. Even people that you don't even go to school, they are even better than some graduate in where I come from. And it's not supposed to be so. So in Ghana, you will see their university students were educated. Yes, if university students talk to you in Ghana, you will know that, yes, this person is educated. This person go to school. With the way the person will talk to you, nobody will tell you that, yes, this person is a graduate. But in where I come from, some people will talk to you, some graduate will talk to you, you will be saying, this person did not even go to school at all. This person did not go to school at all. You don't know that the person is even a graduate. And that isn't supposed to be so. So, if you have any member of your family that you want that person to be educated, as in re-education, educated so that if the person finish university, as in he can defend his or herself that is a graduate of so university, please enroll the person in Ghana University. Just enroll your person in Ghana University. So I think I'm going to round up this blog here. So if you like this video, please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like and share my video and give it a thumbs up. And see you guys on my next one. Bye bye.